Hi, Stefan. How are
Hello.
you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well. How are you?
Thank you. I'm good. I hope you too.
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm usually very excited doing these though, because sometimes, especially if I love a movie so much, I have so much in my mind and then I'm like, anyways, I'll try my best. So thanks for sending your movie to our festival. It was an honor and we're so excited that although I'm not much into awards because it is subjective, but still congratulations for being a finalist.
Thank you very much.
So for me, I would like to start with this. Like for me, if I had to say one thing about Fabio, I could say it's a movie about love. And that's something I really liked because it is a love between man and wife, between people. And I don't want to offend anybody, but especially in this current climate, we get a lot of movies that try to tackle the issue of LGBT, the gay issues, but sometimes they're more narrow. Maybe it's normal. As I said, I don't want to offend anybody. Because where there is oppression, then the revolt comes from there, which is sexuality. But in the end, this is about two people loving whatever sex. I mean, in the end, we love. We must be free to love who we want. And sometimes I'm so sad when it's reduced to sexuality. Actually, one of the poets I love so much, like Rambo, Arthur Rambo, he's very well known to be gay, and Verlaine is his lover. And I always forget that he is gay, for example. I never think of his sexuality first. I always think of his poetry and his love with Verlaine and their fights. They kill one another, try to shoot one another and everything. So for me, Fabio stood out with that, like it was wider angle, and I really liked it because there's then more solidarity even with, if that was what you intended. So then my question, first question could be like, why did you involve this LGBT issue, and are you satisfied with the how you handle the topic, and do you agree with what I say? Was it ever in your mind also to look at the love instead of more sex? Because even Fabio character, when he says, no, it's not like this, it's like this, again, it was so much reinforced in the movie, the love. So did I get it correct?
I'm very glad that you see it like this. And that you say it's not just about LGBT love, it's not just about sex, it's a universal topic about love. That was very important for me, that this movie isn't just interesting for LGBT people, and that it's also interesting and maybe that it can also make people think about themselves who are not identifying with LGBT people. Because I think it's about realizing that life has to end someday, and so we don't have very much time to follow our desires. And so that's a universal thought I think that I had, and that I hope my English is good enough. In German you I would say much better things.
Oh, that's
but,
okay.
But I'm trying. Yes.
I'm okay with English, I guess, but my problem is I speak very fast when I'm excited. So I have a problem as well. Don't worry. Sometimes when I'm excited, I talk as if my English is much worse than normal. So we'll be fine. I think we'll be fine. So it's surely I wasn't surprised when you mentioned time, that we don't have money, because it's in your movie. There is this clock. We hear the clock a lot. And then we see skin of elderly people a lot, which for us, it's time. It was a representation of time for me. And also, I loved it so much that the contrast, both the time and also how the movie talks about what this man might have lost. The kid's voice, the voice, maybe if there's a nearby school or something or a playground. Yeah. So that sound was really very nice for me. And it's also, when I thought about the movie, many of such small details, not saying so much in script, or not so much showing something, it really is elegantly powerful. So I really like that this you just made some things, maybe in first watch we wouldn't even understand first, because they're put there, and sometimes some things are done so with math nearly, it looks so easy, and the first watch you might really miss it. But the strength of a movie when you watch again, so Fabio is really that strong, you watch again and you something else, you see something else. So it's really, I really like those things.
So much.
Yeah, and so because this time, and because this time for me was so much in the elderly skin, we saw a lot, elderly skin, the face, everything. So what was your, how did you think of making an elderly character? Maybe you already said a little bit the time, maybe you wanted to
Ask,
but is there anything else? Is there a fear of yours? Like most of us fear old age, actually, and anything that you didn't just say, if there's something about elderly in the movie?
Yeah, I'm definitely interested in elderly people and in aging since many years. I don't know why. Maybe I have to go to a psychotherapist or something. And yeah, I'm also fearing to age. I don't know why, but because I think it must be sorry I need to
that's okay
focus.
That's fine.
I tell you why I came up with this story. The story is that about 10 years ago I had a nightmare where I saw myself as an old man who is going to die, who realizes that he's going to die, and who knows that he missed many, many things in his life, that he missed to love a man, and he regrets his life. Mm-hmm. And to see myself as an old man in this dream was very, very intense for me. And so I realized that the time has come for me to change something and to confront myself with my feelings. And that made me come out as gay. And this experience and these feelings I wanted to put into this story. And I realized that I need to change something because I saw myself as an old man. Because I realized time is running up
you're
one
being
day.
Tangent to some. Yeah, actually, that is surely one of the backbone of the movie. Like this man lost something, couldn't have something, and he is even too late now. But it's so interesting that you yourself show, actually, it's really, I'm glad that you saw this nightmare then. I'm glad, I hope things are better now that you're not going to be tangent to things. But for me, I also, how can I say, this character, it's interesting that just from a nightmare, you really worked on it in a great way, because I don't know how it happened then now that I learned how it happened. The character is very strong, and actually lately in my life, I'm 46, I don't fear aging as much. I even think an old person like us, like if you're always reading and thinking, and the brain is so, so precious. Like we, a brain of 80, for example, if you're 80 years old, I'm thinking my brain probably will be even better than now. I mean, I'll correct more mistakes. So I decided maybe mostly, yes, this fear of the body collapsing, we can't do much, or maybe we'll look ugly or something. But this character, that's why if, in a sense, if you're fearing old age, he's one character you made that can make us not fear. He's very strong. He has a sense of humor despite this loss in his life. And then he also, he's always in the present. And I thought it's also the movie supports him in being in the present. For example, you did no flashback. When I was watching it first time, I had a moment I was like, no flashback. I thought, I don't know when, there was a moment in the movie I'm like, don't do a flashback, don't, because I was like, it's gonna make it weaker. I thought it made it so strong that he smells Fabio's shorts and then he sees his naked body, or there's this guitar remembering the youth and they have a nice moment. It's always in the present. Maybe at that moment we can think that maybe he goes, he makes a flashback in the brain, but you don't show it. So it also shows you that he maybe kept his sanity by always being present in the present. Maybe that's how he handled this life. That, and you also wonder why he couldn't be with a, you know, a man. Then you maybe think because he's so much full of love and caring for his wife, and also for Fabio, he always wants to help. He listens. Some people don't listen to other people's stories. He listens to his immigrant story and everything. So maybe you think his parents, maybe this man, he loved his parents so much, or some relative that couldn't handle it, the gay topic, and maybe he couldn't, he couldn't do anything because of love. You just wonder. But I really think he's a powerful man, and he's also elegant. As I said, this elegance has also affected me. He wants to kiss him, but he changes his mind and everything. He's like, he's strong, elegantly handling his problem. Like, he's not, there's no abuse of our emotions anywhere. We are not even made to feel sad for him much. Like, we are really made to maybe understand his pain in a maybe through our intelligence, not our emotions. And maybe, yes, maybe if we have a person who we know is struggling, his parents are like, in Turkey, sometimes parents kill gay kids and things. Because it doesn't give us too much emotion that we can be drowned in, it's more like thought. I really like it because emotional topics can really be drowned in cinema so quickly. So I really liked him. So is he a professional? Like, how did you really elaborate this character like this greatly? And plus, if this man who acts, Gustav, I think. Oh, okay. It was, see, a professional actor, but not to say that the other two actors are bad. I'm just like talking about him a little bit.
Yeah, as you said that you liked how his character is you said that there is so much power to feel when in him, and what I wanted to say is many of this brought in from Günter Thora and his life experience.
So what Günter Thora? I didn't understand. What do you mean, Günter Thora?
Günter Thora is the lead actor, is Arthur, the actor who played Arthur. And he is such an optimistic and funny man, and he brought many of his own, much of his own character into the role. And I also rewrote the script after I knew that Günter Thora will play the role. And I like the scene where they're singing together. I wrote it because I knew that Günther Toller will play the role, because I saw on YouTube that he sings very good, and I thought, oh wow, maybe that's good for the role of Arthur. It would enrich this character. There is more of his past. He was a singer. There's more than just a sad old man. Mm-hmm. And also there are tiny jokes in the dialogues, and mm-hmm. also these jokes I wrote after casting Günther Toller.
Okay.
So I guess with another actor the script would have been more depressing.
Yeah. Okay. Then I'm really happy that you found this person. So you knew him already?
Yeah.
I knew him because
in Austria he was actually the first famous man who came out as gay in the end of the 80s, I think. He was a TV host and one of the most important TV figures in Austria. So he wasn't really an actor. But it was very hard to find someone who would play Arthur. I casted several very well-known actors, but they all refused to play the role because they didn't want to confront themselves with their aging. They said mm-hmm. it's too personal for them. They don't want to show their body in front of the camera.
All right.
And
interesting.
After we had to reschedule our shoot because we couldn't find an actor.
Okay.
And then came Günther Toller into my mind and I wrote him, and after 1 hour he answered and said, wow, this script is so good, I want to play this role. And then we met, and I knew that he is perfect for the role.
Yeah, he is. And now that I learned, he's also gay and came out and everything. And it doesn't show, like, sometimes these things show. Some people really make this cast, it's already there in their own stories, similarities, this and that. But then when they shoot something, it shows so much that they intentionally put this person or whatever. As I said, there is something very, very, very plain and elegantly done. It's nice that we don't feel that pressure that he also is a gay or whatever. It is wider look, yeah. And as I said, love, and you made it, that's why you could have made it more love, and I really liked it in that sense a lot. And I always feel something about curtains in the movie, even because I'm pre-selection jury member. I watched a lot of entries last 2 years, and I'm like, maybe we should do something about the meaning of curtains in cinema. And then I thought yours was really so interesting, because curtains witness our life, but they can't speak, but they witness. They hang there, they're always there, and sometimes they protect us. It has so much symbolism for me in a curtain. And in your movie, you used it so perfectly. It sometimes was, again, like time, they witness, click, clock. Sometimes some things he couldn't say. You didn't have the character might say, I missed doing this. He never says anything to even Fabio. Even in the last scene, one day I met this man, but I couldn't, nothing. But a couple places, the curtains already as if collected everything that is not said, but we sense, and they say it as if we even wonder how the wife might have witnessed what in this man. Maybe she could have caught him and sometimes sad and things. Also, everything. So really, did you have any other intentions of using the curtains in that way, or?
It wasn't that much intended. Okay, it's when Fabio came, there is this wind that makes the curtain move into the room. And it's a bit of the world that comes inside with Fabio into this apartment, in this, we wanted these curtains as a wall between their inner life and the life outside. Mm-hmm. It was symbolic, yeah. But as when I listened to you, then I think, wow, what great thoughts you have.
Yes, really, but this is art. We sometimes do something and we don't even know. There's even more and more if you're good in our artistry. So this is how it is. I actually write. I'm a writer. So
I can feel it.
Yeah. So sometimes I also write something. Somebody tells me they understood much different. I'm happy. That means there was interwoven, multi-layered, and sometimes our brain doesn't create something just at the moment. It all our processes in the brain. We sometimes do this, and it's the beauty of being involved in arts. Actually, arts is really a healing power as well. Let me think. Look what I missed. I have a question. The scene that where Fabio caresses or hugs or this in the bed, why didn't you shoot the full head of Arthur? Why isn't her, you, there's the cushion is also showing, the orange cushion was, why did you shoot the, why did you put the angle like that?
That's how you watch the movie. Really, wow. That's the only shot in this movie that I made. This was the one time I wanted to have the camera, because as I don't wanted to have a beautiful angle or a beautiful picture. I wanted to have a camera view that makes something with you, not that you don't feel comfortable. Okay. Like he is not feeling comfortable. So it was more about what you feel when you see this camera angle, and it should irritate you. And it did.
All right. Yeah, I later saw in
my cameraman said, no, we cannot do this. That doesn't look good. But I said, but I think we need it.
Yeah, maybe there's a moment sometimes there's really a hello to the audience. Maybe it is your moment with that, like a little bit knock-knock, something, but it's not. Because afterwards he sits on the bed. Then you see half of the bed is done. Half of the bed shows just bed itself, and they're old designs. Sometimes we don't have those kind of designs anymore. So I thought again it was a little bit showing the time because of the design. You know, sometimes you see wallpapers, you would understand this is not this year, it must be minimum 40 years old or whatever. So I also thought about time there, but anyway, yeah, it was nice. So I'm glad I asked the question. So is there anything you would like to tell our audience before we say bye?
I think, as I said, the main message of this movie is that we need to realize it's not a very special thought, but I think sometimes we need to realize that our life will end. We don't know when, but it will happen. And sometimes the only chance to do something is now. And that's what was what I intended to transport with this story, this thought.
It's very strong. It is a message that actually it's okay repeating, in my opinion. There are some things in our life we can hear it often because we keep forgetting. It's like carpe diem, right? Seize the day.
To choose the perspective of ourselves as old man or woman. I think that's it helps sometimes.
Yeah, but thank you so much. As I said, at age 46, I already started being more peaceful with aging because I decided I like my brain better than in 20s. I like my brain now, but yeah, really, it's the truth. It's the simple truth. So okay, we should be a little bit careful, yes, with the body, not to be skinny or whatever, but a little bit healthier so our brain, we can pass more things to people, that we don't go away quick. We can keep producing with our better brains. And I'm so thankful. If I ever fear holding, I will always remember your movie. So danke schön for that.
I have to say you're the best interviewer I ever had.
Really. Oh really?
Oh, so beautiful what you said about our movie. Wow, thank you so much.
Well, I thank all your crew and you as well. Hats off to you. And I'm so happy to hear that. As I said, I'm so excited and I can't talk properly, but I am also learning, trying to talk and Zoom. And hopefully one day we can meet face to face. Maybe I can, if I talk too fast, maybe I can do my, I can do better slowing down. But it was really nice talking to you. And I really congratulate your team again. And it's an honor. I'm really happy you sent your movie to us. Thanks so much for that. Danke schön. And hopefully we'll see your other movies in our future festivals.
Yeah, I just finished another one and I definitely will submit it to the next edition.
Okay, we look forward to that then. Yeah. Have a nice day and take care.
Have a nice day too and a great festival time. I hope it's going well.
Yeah, it is. Thanks so much. Nice. Thank it you. Was great meeting you and hi to your team as well and bye.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.